Hello there, I'm AJ Puzzleferous, and welcome back to Valheim, where we were on day 6, but now we're on day 14, because I have been doing mining, and in the process, I have extended this little house to include loads of chests to contain all of our goodies. Now, this one contains loads of stone, as you can see. That's what you get when you do mining. But we also have loads of ore, in that we have some tin, 30. We have 60 copper bits. And then we've got another bit of tin over here and another 27 bits of copper. But they're all ore at the moment. And that's because I haven't got the things that I need to turn the ore into not ore, i.e. bars. So, we need stuff to turn that ore into bars. But first, I'm going to show you exactly what I do with the mining, which isn't going to take long. And then we're going to go and see if we can find a dungeon, because in order to turn our ore into bars, we need to get stuff from the dungeon. So, what I've been doing is I have been flattening a little bit of a path over here, which will take us over to a mining site, or one of our mining sites. This is what I discovered via other people's YouTube videos, which is always useful, is the best way to deal with ore nodes. Now, this particular copper ore chunk, as you can see, I've dug all around it, because when you find an ore chunk, dig all around it, and you'll see that only that tiny bit there was above ground, apart from a little bit over there, and then you can see that there's tons more out here, all the way around it, which is really cool, because we've got loads of ore to mine. So, that is how much ore you tend to get in one of these chunks. Quite a lot of ore, but obviously if you don't dig down, then you only see what is on the very surface of the ground. How many enemies? Are you not finished? Still, it's all good training. As we've got the rested thingy, then I think we get more experience from having that. I'm not sure. I can't remember. Anyway, so that is one that is in the process of being started off. Wait a minute, are you going to try and hit me or what? Well, anytime soon. Come on. And then we grab that and then bash. And another bash. And then you die. Great, because I want that stuff. Thank you. Brilliant. So, as I said, I made a little path because it's really handy to have a little path that's just over there to where I want to go. This is definitely the mountains. I want to explore that in time, but at the moment, not so much, because we're doing this. Now, over here, we have another one of the ore nodes. Now, this node, unlike the last one... Oh, can I even get up there? I'm going to have to go round. Okay, let's go round. Now this node, unlike the other node, I mostly excavated by way of a wonderfully large troll over there that we marked on the map. Now that troll, if you start digging over here, then this troll gets angry at you and it charges over and it will demolish things in its path. Now if this was actually in the middle of the forest in a more convenient place, then it would be really convenient to get the troll to break all of the rock for us, because it takes so little time. The troll just bashes its way through it, so it's really awesome to use a troll, and that is what I was doing with that one. I just wanted to show you that that particular ore node troll, I trolled it. But the ore node that I've been working on, a bit like that one, but I've been working on one that was right across from our home. So we've got the home on one side of the river, as you can see on the little top corner of the map. And on the other side of the river, we've got a little circle, which is where our ore node is. And that ore node, I have been digging. And it's got only a little tiny, tiny thing holding it up now. So this is displays how digging around the ore node works. What you do is you dig all of the way around it, leaving it suspended in midair like a UFO, but there's just a little tiny, tiny bit of stuff holding it up. Tiny! So what we're going to do is we're going to dig that tiny, 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 tiny bit of stuff. And hopefully, once we have dug all of that tiny stuff... Yeah, this is what happens, you see. You think that it's going to crash to the ground, but in actual fact, it's all managed to stay exactly where it was. Look at that. So it's actually all floating now. Isn't it? Is there any bit of it that's actually touching something? No, there's nothing that's actually touching something. So, presumably, if I start hitting this, then it should fall. I hear a lot of bashing. Is it going to fall? I've done this before, and it just usually falls down, so I don't know. Is that going to fall? No, apparently we can have floating rock. Interesting! Okay, so a bit of it collapsed, but not all of it. Is this all going to collapse? Let's see. Break! Yes, it does all collapse. Excellent. And we have plenty more ore to go in our collection. Well, why didn't it all break? You would have thought that now that it has absolutely nothing to suspend it, it would all just break and fall to the floor. But for some reason, things hold each other up. Yeah, you're holding it up. How does that work? I don't get it. We're going to get clobbered by bad guys soon. Ah, I wasn't there with my shield fast enough. Yeah, good. And beat you. Good. Excellent. That wasn't so bad. Okay, so I thought that was going to just collapse all in one massive heap, but evidently it's not going to do the fun thing. It's just going to do the I'm going to go slowly and not do the fun thing. So I don't know. I don't get that. Oh, there we go. There we go. That's exactly what I expected it to do. Okay, so let's get rid of this. And then we've got all of the copper. Stop picking up stone. I don't want stone. Ah. So there you go. If you dig all around the outside, then actually you can make it so that you get all of the copper in one go. And it's fun. It's just fun. That's what it is. Now, it's going to take me ages to go back there and back again. Ah, I want stuff. Okay. Seen as I mean, this will probably be the last of the picking up of copper that I'll have to do, because we've got so much copper now. Ooh, hello, don't swim when you're out of energy. This is a general life tip. If you're swimming when you're out of energy, you're probably going to drown. And drowning is definitely bad for your health. So yeah, over here with all of the copper. And we have so much stone. I mean, at some stage, I'm going to be able to build stone constructions. And the pure amount of stone that we're picking up here is going to make it so much easier to build any stone construction that we could possibly want. All right. I need to get more tin as well. But at the moment, having done that... I feel good about this. Jumping into the water really does cover a good amount of the water before you get to the land again on the other side. So it's quite helpful to jump if you okay with that. Right, let's grab some more copper. I don't know if this disappears if you leave it too long. I definitely hope not. Okay, you can go away. You can go away. But you really don't get much copper for the amount of stone that you get. So there really isn't a lot of copper in a copper vein. But all we can do is try our best and throw away all of the stone we don't want. Yes. Give me the copper. No room for stone anymore. Okay, so we'll go over there. I'm going to have to carry stacks of stone back again. So much stone and copper. I tell you what, I will continue to grab these things. And then I shall see you once I've actually transported them all to the chest, so you don't have to watch me transporting stone and copper to chests. Alright, so I have transported a ton of stone and a bunch of copper over to there. And now what we're going to do is we are going to find ourselves a dungeon. Now, there's a dungeon over there, but that's a really long way away. Maybe we'll be able to find a dungeon over here. Let's have a look through the middle of the forest, because this is like the only place that we didn't search. Hello there, dear. You're just going to stand there? Really? You not see me? No, you don't see me. Okay. But you're also running off. Okay, fine. So you do see me. All right, picky. Hello there. Stop appearing and disappearing. You need to lighten your load. Yes, I know. Don't carry too much stuff. Got it? I will ignore that advice in no time. Oh. What was that? Sounded almost like a troll. Never mind. We're after the dungeon. And if we can find one over here, that'd be great. If we can't, then there's always the other one that we found. I'm gathering the thistle because loads of thistle. At least the thistle is really easy to see, even in the night and the day, easy to see. All right. Do need to be a little bit careful. I have been making loads of fire arrows because fire arrows, they are good for everything. I mean, at this stage anyway. Later on, they're good against the Draga as well, and the balls of goopy stuff. The balls of goopy stuff and the Draga really easy to kill with the bow and arrow and the fire arrows, as it were. But we need hello there. This is a weird one. Is this just the usual one? Just the usual one? Yeah, it's just the usual one. Okay. But it's not going to help us with our mission for dungeons. Still, we're heading in the right direction, which is good. I'm dry again. That's also good. Right. There seems to be stuff here. Yes. We have carrot seeds. But we haven't actually started using carrots yet. That looks like a place that I should mark. All right. Let's get blue. And four. Excellent. Right, now, where are these blummin' dungeons? There's got to be a dungeon somewhere. It's funny, I'm going around with the bow and arrow, but I'm probably going to swap to the axe as soon as I get anywhere near anything. Because we'll get attacked by skeletons, most likely. The skeletons, I can deal with them with the axe, that's no problem. I could shoot them with the bow really easily. I mean, there's no problem with that either, but... A dungeon! Brilliant! About time. This one's not marked off on the map. Have they seen me? No, they haven't. Okay. So let's dump this over here. I think that's a dungeon! Excellent. And we will go over there. I could totally shoot them, but it seems like a waste of arrows. Ah, let's do it anyway. Hey, you! Ah! Gotcha. And you will burn, and break to pieces and give me that stuff. But what I'm actually after are things deep in the dungeon, deep inside. There's another two skeletons around here somewhere. Where are they? Hiding. Hello there, skeleton. I see you. And you're a bow and arrow skeleton, so I definitely want to get rid of you. Ah, sneak attack. Wonderful. Down in one. Great, but where's the other one? Ah, another one that's just hiding. Yes! Another sneak attack. Brilliant. This does quite nicely. Quite nicely indeed. I don't need a skull. There's so many things that I pick up that I just don't need. Hello there. Treasures lie below. Delves and dungeons can be found across the 10th world. They are monuments of the past, and most often filled with the riches of civilizations long lost. Remember to bring a light source. Yeah, forget the light source. I'll probably turn the light brightness up for you, because it's going to be dark in here. And it is going to be dark in here. I'm not going to do much about that, because it's actually quite helpful for it to be quite dark, because then they don't see you as much. So actually, I'm going to go with the dark. Let's open this. Oh, he saw me. Hi, have some light. In your face! Okay, this is considerably more danger than I was expecting. Okay, are we going to be okay with this? No, we're not going to be okay with this. We are going to die horribly. Can they get up this? You know what? I think they're stuck. Hey, you. Hey, you with the stuckness. Get over here. Get over here and get deaded. You're walking all over the place. Hey, you. Gotcha. No, I don't want to get hit by him. Hi, you. Oh, this is quite handy. Just hide over here. You can't do anything about me because I'm here and you're not. Come on then. Come on. Dare you. Ooh, this is cheap. Cheap attacks, always the best. Okay. He's gonna die soon. He is gonna die soon. Come on. Come on. I dared you already. Let's see if we can get some light on this just so that we can see what we're doing. Oh, right. Great. If I change to the light, then it takes the everything that I would defend myself with away from me. Oh, I missed. No, get out. Get out. Oh, dear. Okay, there's two of them. Hi. Yeah. I missed your friend. There. He's dead. Now, consider joining him. I mean, you were already dead, so that's fine, but, you know. Be more dead! More dead, I tell you! The amount of dead in you is not enough. I disagree with it. Alright. And he breaks to smithereens. Excellent. Now we need more life. Okay, so let's eat up, and then we can get in there and see what goodies we can find. Alright, ah, there's another one. Block! And smash! Excellent. I can fight in melee in this, which is a surprise because I'm usually terrible at melee stuff, but I can actually. Now, I know it's really super dark. I know this, but we're just having a look around. That's it. If you just concentrate on the floor, then you're relatively okay in the super dark. It doesn't really matter. Okay. Wow, it's dark. Wow, it's dark. Ooh, we've got some bones over here. Right. And there's nothing over there. Right, there are these around, and they're kind of helpful, but they're not really brilliantly helpful. They're just a little helpful. So really, you just need to know where you're going. You know what? I'm going to try and get one of these working. Let's have that off and that on. Right, okay. Just so that we can attack them, or just so we can see around where we're going. No. I don't usually use that at all. Well? Can I just get him from around the corner? Yeah. Oh, he's a one of those. Oh, they're both one of those. Wow. No, 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 back off. Okay. Yeah. Ah, see? Now I'm going to shoot you. Because it's considerably easier. Hi. Yeah, you stand there doing that. That's fine. That's not going to be your death at all. Yeah. Ooh, we've got to watch out for the other one. Hey, you! Arrow in the face. And another arrow for good measure. Hi there. You want to join the fun? Yes. Of course you do. Why wouldn't you? It's a flaming good time. Get over here! Oh, I ran out of stamina. That's no good. Okay. Missed! Missed! How many arrows we got? Loads! Excellent. Good. This is why I prepare myself with so many arrows. Because I know I'm going to need them. Hello there. Hi. Wait a minute. Just jumping. Gotcha! And a bit more. Yes! Brilliant! Another shattered skeleton. Hey! You know, if I creep, I might be able to get him without him actually waking up to the fact that I'm here. No, I won't. Oh, hello! Another one. Hi. You're not as powerful as the others. So you get to die pretty quickly. Because, not as powerful as the others, and you made the mistake of trying to attack me. Alright. Do we have anything cool in here? No! Another nothing. They better have a something at some stage, because at the moment that's totally nothing in all directions, isn't it? Right, let's go in here and see if we can find anything else. I can't see any more than you can, just so you know. Oh, it's a ghost. They're a bit of a pain. Okay, so he's tried to slice me. Ow, 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 ow. Can I just shoot you from here? Because you seem to be just hanging around the door. Do you get hit by arrows? Yes, you do get hit by arrows. How you can hit a ghost with arrows, I do not know. I mean, ghosts are supposed to move through things, but they can't get through the door, so, you know. If they can't get through the door, that is their problem. Ah. Okay, there's nothing else in here. Apart from these. Let's have a look at what we're looking at. This is what we want. We want these. The Searchling Core? Searling Core? Okay, we need those. Because we needed the smelter and the other thing that's not the smelter. That's basically what our target was. I can't believe how few of these cores there are in this place. You can pick up rubies as well, but, you know, I never find the shopkeeper, and as I never find the shopkeeper, I never find a need for rubies, because no shopkeeper equals no need for rubies. Alright. Is that it? Is that this entire place? We've gone through this entire place and we've got two of those cores? Two? Two cores. Just in case you don't know, two cores is not enough to build anything. You need five for that, and you need five for that. So without five, nothing. But we have indeed gone through an entire dungeon and found all it had to offer, really. A ruby and a bit of other stuff, and now it's really dark. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to our house, because nighttime in the forest is the time where all of the monsters come out, and so it spawns considerably more monsters than it would spawn at other times. As such, we definitely want to get back to our house as fast as we can, especially when there's big monsters around, that one being one of them. He has a very large bludgeon, which he likes to introduce you to, or your face to, and he's really good at it. So yeah, we really need to get out of here as fast as we can. Oh, I'm heading straight for the troll. That's not a good plan. Okay, it's so easy to get turned round in the forest, because it's very obviously dark at the moment, and also because it's a forest. And forest is just generally easy to get turned around in anyway. Here we have the wonders of the thistle, which I'm definitely going to pick up. There seems to be another one. No, there's another one. Okay, fair enough. But we need to get home as fast as possible. Ah, we're increasing our run. Good. And our jump. Yes. Really, I need our bonus from the boss character to be active, because then I can do lots of running and jumping and everything, and it's all fine. What's this? Is there a little river down here? There's a little river down here. Brilliant. This is a place that I've been digging tin from, and I need to dig more tin, because we've only got a certain amount of tin, and that's just not enough tin. So what I'm going to do is I am going to raid another dungeon, and I am going to gather some more tin. And then what I will do, once I've gathered the more tin and raided another dungeon, is I will be able to actually make those things that we've sort of prepared the way for, because we've got loads of stone and everything. So now we've got loads of stone and everything, I should be able to use those to start the wonders of building copper things, and copper things and tin things result in bronze things, and the bronze things we can use to actually successfully make new armor and equipment, and we'll finally be out of the Stone Age and into the Bronze Age. Right, let's get over there. Oh, please don't drown on the way. It would be really embarrassing to drown just outside my house. Don't dare. Okay, we're all right. I had a horrible sinking feeling there. All right. Oh, we got a one of these to defeat just outside. Yeah. Yeah. You can give me all of your things as well. Hand them over. Thank you. Great. In we go. And another night is successfully done. Let's close the door. Oh, I'm wet. I need to dry out. That doesn't take long at all, thankfully. Great. In bed. And then we will see you the next day. But I shall see you in the next episode. In the meanwhile, you take care. Thanks for watching. Feel free to watch other things on my channel. Feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. See you next time. Bye for now.